aircon is so loud. That's the background noise. I apologize, but this is the nicest place to film. Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. I wanted to get back to posting every Saturday. Things have been a bit weird since I started traveling and since I've been here with time zones and everything. But I've kind of figured it out a little bit, so I figured I'd post another video this Saturday. So today's video, I wanted to talk to you guys about why I ended up at Warwick. I know the title of this is a little bit misleading because it says why I chose Warwick, and the thing is, I did choose Warwick, but it was my insurance choice rather than my first choice. So I will answer that question along with a lot of others, specifically about just basically how I ended up at Warwick. I was gonna say here, but not there. How? That's a jet. Okay, so for those of you who don't know me, my name is Maya. I am a now second year, going into my second year, a biomed student at the University of Warwick. And basically, I didn't initially choose Warwick as my first university, my first choice. When I was still doing my A-levels and I was doing all my UCAS processing, when it came time to actually pick my universities, my top choice had actually been originally Oxford, but when I didn't get an interview for that and I was left with just my four other choices, I had actually had Imperial as my first choice. That being said, I did knowingly make Warwick my second choice, and I'll get into the details of why I did that later on, but also how I ended up at Warwick and why I didn't end up at Imperial. And just, you know, aside, I really like Warwick, and I'm really happy that I'm here, there. And if I were to go back in time, I wouldn't change it and get myself into Imperial. I would continue and get myself, I would probably even put Warwick first. Right, so diving straight in, you know, throwback to year 12, year 13, A-levels, UCAS, university choices. I knew that I wanted to apply to top universities, and I knew that I wanted to apply for biomedical sciences. Those were the two things that I knew 100% I was going to do. That being said, I didn't know which universities, and that's when I started my research. Oxford had always been kind of like a distant dream of mine, even when I lived in the States, didn't even know what UK education was like. I just had an inkling towards studying in the UK, and being very, very, very locally American, I didn't really know other universities other than Oxford and Cambridge. So Oxford was like my basis dream. As I got older, and then eventually when I moved into the UK education system, I figured out that there are a lot more universities in the UK that are fantastic and in some ways even better than Oxford in certain courses for certain people. And with that, I started doing more research, so I discovered Imperial, because Imperial is right up there with Oxford and Cambridge. It's a fantastic university to go to. Two of my old classmates from my school got into Imperial for biomed. I've spoken to them, they really love their course. But aside from Oxford and Imperial and, say, UCL and, like, that small little group, you've got other top universities that just, from my experience, weren't that talked about. So Warwick came into the picture partially because one of the people who was 2 years older than me applied to Warwick, so he got into Warwick when I was still doing my GCSEs.
Well, he got in and finished his year 13 when I finished GCSEs. So my year 12, he started his first year at university.
Yes, okay. So I knew a student studying at Warwick, not biomed, but still. Also, my maths teacher and my sixth form tutor both went to Warwick, and so I had heard a lot of good things about it, and I decided to start doing a little bit of research on it on my own when I was looking for my courses. Turns out that Warwick had a fantastic School of Life Sciences, and specifically biomedical sciences, which is what I was looking at, because not every university offers biomedical sciences. But the course at Warwick was just extremely, extremely detailed and kind of covered everything that I could imagine myself possibly doing. And I have not decided what I want to do after my degree yet, so I really do need to try everything that I could possibly see myself doing. And that's why I'm so, so happy with Warwick. Which gets me down to, why did I pick Warwick as my second rather than my first? So as I said, Oxford was my big dream, and I didn't get into Oxford because there were multiple factors. They didn't really explain why I didn't necessarily get an interview, but I did get an interview. So I moved on from that and decided, okay, if I can't get into Oxford, I'll get myself into Imperial. Because somewhere in the back of my mind, I was still kind of under the conception of, you know, other than Oxford, Cambridge, and Imperial, it's not really worth going to a UK university. And that was a really bad mindset for me to have, but you have to keep in mind that I was very international. I had never been in the UK for more than 3 days at a time, and I didn't really know what universities were like, so cue open days. I managed to go to an open day at Imperial and at UCL, and I will say I absolutely loved the open day at Imperial, and I think that was a huge factor as to why I set it as my first. I never made it up to Warwick, and that was because mostly I kind of had like a one-streak mind set on Imperial. When it came down to choosing my insurance choice, I was actually very, very stuck between Warwick and the University of Edinburgh because it had a very good course in Biomed as well. Finally, what pushed me towards putting Warwick as my insurance choice rather than the University of Edinburgh was mostly just the course details. Warwick's course seemed more lab, hands-on, and it covered more topics than what was at Edinburgh. And for me, that was just more what I was looking for. I was looking for something a little bit more in-depth, it covered a bit more topics, and that was Warwick for me. Looking back on it, actually comparing what the course offers, the course at Imperial and the course at Warwick is so much more what I was looking for. I think when I was making my decision, I was just so blindsided by the idea of getting into Imperial, but I didn't really bother to compare the courses of Imperial and Warwick as much as I did with Warwick and Edinburgh. So fast forward to my results day, you're all wondering, you know, Imperial is a fantastic school, why didn't I go there? Why did I go to Warwick? And really, the reason is that I just didn't get the grade for Imperial. I was 1A off from Imperial, and when I got my results and I saw that, and I got the UCAS letter that said, you know, we're declining you at Imperial, I was disappointed at first, because obviously that was the dream that I had set up as soon as I got the no from Oxford. Imperial was my everything at the moment. But as soon as I got that, I started looking into Warwick. And the more I looked into Warwick, and the more I looked into the degree, and the course, and the people, and the location, and then I started speaking to the people that I knew who had gone to Warwick about it, and the more information that I found out, the more I realized that I should have picked Warwick as my first choice. And I'm not saying this now just to get you into Warwick. I'm saying this objectively, because everything about Warwick was just so much more what I wanted. It's a campus uni, and I realized later I didn't want to live in the city, because having spoken to my friend who lives in London, I just realized that her lifestyle that she's living just doesn't fit into the way that I would want to live. Yes, someday I probably will live in a big city, and I do want to experience that, but I definitely think that for me personally, it's not the uni experience that I wanted. So first bonus was it was campus uni. And like I said, I hadn't looked at Warwick much. I really didn't give a lot of thought to Warwick until after I got declined from Imperial. So I didn't know what it looked like. I'd never been to the campus. I didn't really look into it much until it came time to apply for accommodation and all that. And I found out so many positive things about Warwick. I absolutely love the campus. I love the people. I love the fact that it's so close to things. Like, I can easily go into Coventry, I can easily go into Leamington, and there are things to do there. But at the same time, it's kind of isolated. I'm not in a big city. There's not a constant noise surrounding me, which for me personally is fantastic. I love the course. So getting a little bit more nitty-gritty into the course, I've said before, it covers a lot more topics. So the difference, huge difference, that is between Imperial's biomed teaching and Warwick's biomed teaching is Imperial, they started doing small lab-based teachings and online, like separate isolated learning, and then coming in and doing tutorials basically. And having now been to lectures at Warwick, and because Warwick does lectures plus private tutorials and labs, I prefer lectures to sitting at home, learning on my own, and then coming in and talking about something. Because there's some sort of feeling of having the lecturer sit and speak to you and explain to you, not necessarily just to you, but to have a general talk. it goes into my head in some way. So I prefer the lecture teaching. I prefer the content of the course as well, because I feel like the first year at Imperial for me would have been too specific, while the first year at Warwick was quite broad and it did cover quite a few different topics, and it's allowing me to go into my second year with a broad idea of what I know I don't want to do, and I'm slowly narrowing down what I do want to do. So I have my module choices coming up in September for next year, and I'm pretty sure I already have a couple of modules that I've completely crossed out. I know I don't want to take them. So ultimately, I ended up at Warwick kind of on accident, but I stayed at Warwick and I made the most of it all because it really is a fitting university for me. My recommendation, I guess, from this takeaway would be, for those of you who are applying and have your heart set on a specific university, find as much information as you can. Try and get a real feel for the university before you brush it off as just an insurance choice. Because you might find that the university that you thought was the university of your dreams isn't. And that's completely okay, you know? Obviously, I feel like this is gonna be different for home students because you guys have grown up in a setting where these universities are probably more talked about and more known than what I grew up in. So, moral of the story, I've already said the moral of my story, but that was my experience, and that is how I ended up at Warwick University. And on that note, I hope you guys have a wonderful rest of your weekend. Enjoy the last bits of summer that we're having before it starts to cool down again. Go outside, just breathe some fresh air, enjoy the warmth, unless it's not warm wherever you are, and in which case, I'm sorry that that's the case and you can't enjoy the warmth. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, give this video a big thumbs up if you liked it, follow my Instagram, and I will see you all next week.